See, here I have written fx equal to this, and I have written x plus 5 equal to 0. So x is equal to minus 5. Now you put x equal to minus 5 here, then every place of x you put minus 5. So minus 5 whole cube, minus 5 whole square, and minus 5. This fx equal to this, and x plus 5 equal to 0 I have written. So x equal to minus 5. Now if you put this minus 5 here, then you are getting 0. That means x plus 5 is a factor. Since x plus 5 is a factor, so x plus 5 you take and divide this expression. This division you have learned in class 7. So you divide. How to divide? You have to make equal to this first term. Then x is there. Then if you put 2x square here, then it will be equal. So 2x square you multiply with this. So it is 2x cube plus 5 to the 10 x square. Now if you subtract, then this will cut, plus minus cut. And then 5x square minus 10 square, it is minus 5x square. The remaining you write here. Again, make minus 5x square here. So what to do? Minus 5x you have to multiply here. Then minus 5x into this, it is giving this thing. Again, you subtract means that make sign change. This minus will be plus, minus will be plus. So minus and plus will cut. Here, see opposite sign, subtraction and sign of greater than minus, that you have to write here. So 3x minus 15. Again, you multiply by minus 3, then it will be minus 3x minus 3 5s are 15. If you subtract, then sign will be changed. So plus minus, it will cut. You see the remainder, the quotient, it is 2x square minus 5x minus 3, that you take here and do middle term factorization. Here you see, break middle term, this 3 2s are 6, 6 you break 6 into 1, so 6 minus 6x plus x. Now factorize, you are getting these two factors. So one factor you have got here, x plus 5, and another two factors you are getting now. So there are total three factors you have got. So this expression equal to three factors you have got by remainder theorem. That's all.